Hello everyone. He is Anand Dwivedi. This year getting 40th rank, and it is a long but great journey that finally he has got a top rank after years of efforts in general, but in EPSC field he has been for quite some time and already in service, right, working as IRS. And his journey I will tell in very brief, that it is source of inspiration for other people, those who are preparing. Every year we bring such kind of results that candidates have a very long journey and they go through ups and downs, and finally they get a top rank. So it is not a myth, or it is not something that ki falsely told when it is told to the students. Today, let's say that ki once again this year you have before you this rank, 40th rank, and it shows that ki his journey, let's say that ki in past few years, so how he has continuously applied efforts with patience and perseverance, and it has ultimately let's paid today. And it is his all hard works, and certainly no doubt ki UPSC has this time liked him. His his everything, it can be his let's say mains interview all, and that's how let's say that ki he is getting a top rank or coming into that top 50. Rest he will share his journey.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I belong to the city of Kanpur. So I hail from the city of Kanpur. I did my graduation from IIT BHU, and thereafter I worked in the private sector as well. Currently, I'm working as the Indian Revenue Service officer. This year, I had worked on nothing major had changed in my preparation strategy. But some of the more emphasis on the areas where I thought I could improve further, or giving certain added advantage to some of the UPSC syllabus that is so vast in terms of the topics that are covered. So this year my strategy was to identify those areas which I can further, and in the areas which I have performed better, just to maintain that performance or even improve there as well. So I think, sir, with a strategy, one has to form a strategy and a plan as how to cover the various topics. And somehow, sir, I think those things clicked for me this year. And probably, sir, waiting for the marks to be released, and then probably a better understanding of how things fared eventually in the exam. But these are some of the things that I focused on in this attempt. So in terms of identifying the areas where I can further improve, either in terms of presentation, or the structure of the answers, understand the demand of the question. Even in the options, like for example, sir, the various the paper, the approach in paper one, as to, because ultimately it's a matter of very few marks. So my approach was just to have certain added advantage in some of these key areas, which where I can improve and identify what are my strengths and opportunities, which in terms of the marks that can be scored.
Especially coming from public administration optional, so it is added, you can say that ki challenge, but getting a rank, so it is also, let's say that ki another, let's say, level of achievement.
Thank you, sir.
Because nowadays people think that ki public administration is an optional, so it is challenging, although not that difficult or impossible, because every year ultimately we are having ranks from that optional.
Yes, sir.
So especially his journey, I know that ki how basically we have every year hundreds of students, and we know largely through their copies and their let's say that ki whatever they are writing tests face to face, very, let's say that ki it happens that ki very rare that ki we meet and etc. But I came to know him personally when he came for an interview program. Although he was part of our institution, but face to face, when I interacted, so I find his personality very perfect.
Thank you, sir.
That time also I told, and many a time we think that why UPSC is not able to identify such personality, that some candidates are so perfect in terms of not only their brain but also their communication, their personality, and somehow let's say that it happens, which we say every year that one should keep trying for, and there can be a way out like this. So I would like to know basically on public administration, because I will say this year public administration, so it can be the first interview also on a successful candidate of public administration, although there are other candidates but we have not yet interviewed. So his view will be certainly, let's say that very valuable for candidates, those who have a bit tensed on public administration. Sir. So how will you share your journey, especially for public administration?
Sir, while opting for public administration, sir, I had an understanding of because in the civil services also one has to have a good understanding of how the administration functions. So this was the major motivation of taking public administration as an optional, sir. So in terms of the preparation, sir, this optional I think demands a more analytical approach as opposed to other optionals. So my approach in this optional has been, sir, that to study the basic core books and then focus on understanding what the demand of the question is, sir. And then probably, sir, the structure and the other things can be taken care of at a later stage, but understanding the demand of the question, sir, because when we see the questions that are asked in the examination, those are lengthy questions at times, and in a matter of very, because per question time is very limited. So that has to be practiced. This is what, based on my experience, the understanding of demand of the question, because when we read the content of the course, then probably, sir, we are able to understand the subject in itself, but what is being asked is something that we have to cater to. And once that is figured out, then I think, sir, this kind of optional can also be read in a very effective manner. And how, I think, sir.
Yes, how will you motivate the candidates, especially those who are upcoming candidates?
Sir, in terms of there are few things. One has to be very thorough with the syllabus. That is the first thing that one has to do. Second would be identifying what are the sources where those syllabus has to be covered. So one has to keep a very minimal set of books or minimal set of sources. And then probably the third step would be revision. The more the revision, the better it is, because the first time one reads it, it would be at a very preliminary level. And subsequently when reads it, then it gets absorbed and one can also tackle the questions which are asked based on the application part of the exam, of the syllabus. Sir. For example, sir, even in the GS, the questions that are being asked require a very analytical approach, sir, and the application of those static parts of syllabus is required. And in the optional also, sir, with a lot of changes in the governance, in the policy era, policy initiatives, sir, I think, sir, these are the three major areas one can focus on, and with the hard work and perseverance, one has to keep striving for it, and eventually things will click. With this positive approach, one has to approach the examination, and then somehow things will click, and just maintain the momentum with you.
What they should do, basically, let's say people, that those who have taken optional.
Sir.
So yes, as far as subject is concerned, that what they have to study, what not they have to study, yes, how they have to study. But then the bottom line is that they feel at times demotivated,
sir.
They compare with other optional.
Sir.
So how you can help them to motivate, in such, which things kept you motivated,
yes, sir.
Basically?
Sir, having an interest in the optional, I think, sir, is the most basic thing, sir. Because one has to study optional it requires an in-depth study of the portions because it's different from the general studies. So having an interest in the subject is the first thing. If one has the interest in public administration, then subsequently the technicalities can be tackled, sir, in terms of answer writing, in terms of attending discussions of the various test series, in terms of evaluating your answers with your peer. That can be tackled. But the basic thing would be, if one has an interest in public administration or some other optional, one should go with it. And then eventually, because of across optional, it has been seen that people score good marks with whatever optional they have taken. If they have covered the syllabus well, if they have tackled the nitty-gritties of those optionals and the the basic thing would be just to be consistent with that option. One should not leave certain parts of that option uncovered, because likewise in public administration, the questions do not cater to just one topic. It might be intertwined with various other topics as well. Mm-hmm. So a holistic perspective has to be adopted in option as well, sir.
Yes, I would basically like to tell that although he may not share those things or he can later stage, but let me tell that just to get this platform, means through this platform I would like to share this, which we every year do that for the people, those who are having public adoptional or those who are thinking to take public adoptional. That in past also it has happened that last year we had, let's say, 11th rank Nupur Goel, and she had also a long journey. There is nothing also shame in saying there is a long journey and one has given this number of attempt. Instead of saying, you know, it was my second attempt or first attempt. So we don't feel that way, we don't teach also in that way. So he had, let's say, that in past 2018 IRS, yes, and then he was in service again at appearing in 19. Yes, and somehow, let's say, not improving, then the 20 and lockdown situation. And you can imagine that he's still in a lockdown situation, crossing that and keep appearing, keeping in this competition and appearing. So many a time when we have a bit disconnection with the candidates, so we feel that he may not be appearing, right? But then when the result, let's say, that comes, then we come to know, oh, he has maintained his motivation, he has maintained his, let's say, perseverance. And you can see it when we say these things in our class. So there is no any such example that we can show that time, although we refer the names, and henceforth we will start referring his name also to motivate candidates the way we, in his time, we have referred some other names. So that is how you should know. But you should know this also, that every year we have such examples and every year results come, and such people make records, and no doubt as getting a rank in UPSC itself is achievement. But yes, getting a top rank is another level of achievement, which you know that very few people will be having such kind of luck, or you can say that whatever you can say, nature, nurture, and God has given, whatever you can say this. But ultimately, let's say that result matters when it comes. And then let's say that things get corroborated or established. Yes, this is how it happens. So he will share also with his, means a bit details, his experience with Lakshmikant about his journey and public administration and preparation. So as far as our interaction is concerned, so we'll let's say that he finish here, and we wish him
thank you, sir,
a very good luck, and let's say that for a new journey, all the best.
Thank you, sir.
Right.
Thank you, sir.